Hi everybody, Riskmonger here, and today I'm going to be playing MLB The Show 20. And shouldn't it be 2020? That's what everyone tells me to do when I'm signing checks or important documents. But they want to go with MLB The Show 20, so I'll be playing MLB The Show 20. Or actually, I won't technically be playing the game per se, but rather using the game engine as a way to simulate one of my favorite personal projects, Fantasy Astrology Baseball. I've been doing this project since way back in 2012, and at its core, it started as a 12-team fantasy league where each team represented one of the 12 signs of the zodiac. I would sort all the MLB players by birth date, which is easier than it sounds considering I already had a running Excel spreadsheet of all the players in the league, and then assign them to the team that corresponded to their astrological signs, and see how things played out over a head-to-head fantasy season. I controlled the rosters for all 12 teams, making changes monthly or weekly, depending on my level of interest that particular year. And over the years, I've expanded the idea to video games. I picked 12 real-life teams to represent the 12 astrology teams, and simulated a full season. I put a lot of work into deciding which teams corresponded to which signs, based on the divisions they played in and the color schemes of their uniforms. But it wasn't until this most recent version of the show that I was able to create custom teams and uniforms that actually represent how each sign might dress on a baseball field. So, since the calendar just turned to Taurus season, I'm going to start this analysis with the roster of the Taurus Bulls, normally represented by the Oakland Athletics due to their forest green color scheme. But now, for the first time ever, they get their own uniforms. Remember, each player in the game is rated on a 1 to 100 scale, and they're going to be organized based on this rating, starting with Yankees outfielder Aaron Judge, who broke into the majors in a big way, winning the 2017 AL Rookie of the Year award. He might have also taken home the MVP trophy were it not for Jose Altuve. A rivalry broke out between these two during the offseason when Judge made some biting comments about the Astros' sign-stealing scandal. But these two will have to put aside their differences if Taurus has any hope of competing. Meanwhile, Matt Chapman has developed into one of the game's top third basemen on both sides of the ball. Speedster Jonathan Villar is blocked by Altuve at second base, but he's got tons of versatility. He qualified at shortstop, and his new team, the Marlins, are considering using him in center field in 2020. Wilson Contreras took over as the top Taurus catcher last year, with Salvador Perez out with an injury. Michael Brantley is another member of those Astros, and one of the game's best professional hitters. Now our top-rated pitcher, Lance Lynn, is not a typical fantasy ace, but he's really come into his own in Texas these past couple years. Joaquin Soria gets such a high rating because of his past history as a lights-out closer for the Royals, but he has declined since then. Miguel Sano is a very important part of this roster, because the Twins are planning to shift him across the diamond to first base, allowing him and Matt Chapman to be in the same lineup. Salvador Perez, as I mentioned, will be returning after a 2019 season loss to Tommy John surgery. Oh, they don't let you change the uniforms of the AAA team, which is why Kevin Kiermaier is wearing the jersey of the Las Vegas Aviators. The reason he's on the Aviators, despite elite defense and top-flight speed, is that Taurus has another player with a similar profile but higher offensive upside in Victor Robles. Jock Peterson serves as a good backup outfielder, and he also gained eligibility at first base last year. Marcus Stroman will act as the team's number two starter. He'll be looking to play his first full season with the Mets, as full as the 2020 season ends up being. Brian Dozier is another player whose rating is based on past success. Austin Meadows will serve as the team's DH. He broke out with the Rays last year. And infielder Jose Peraza I have on the AA Midland Rockhounds. It's kind of strange that he has the same rating as legitimate MLB All-Star Corey Seager, who actually might platoon with Jonathan Villar at shortstop in this simulation. Brian Anderson is a good bench bat, because he can play third base or the outfield. Emilio Pagan probably has first dibs at the team's closer role. He'll be in San Diego next year following a trade from Tampa Bay. And here's where we really see the lack of starting depth for Taurus. Zach Godley had pretty much one good season in the majors, and he had to settle for a minor league deal this year. Michael Givens, the closer for Baltimore, so a fairly decent relief corps for this team, but nothing spectacular. D. Gordon, another base-running specialist. D. Gordon is on the AAA team because there just wasn't a spot for him in the majors. David Hernandez, someone else who had to settle for a minor league deal this offseason, although the game just loves giving high ratings to veteran relievers. If these rosters were based on actual 2020 potential and not the rating system in this game, Aristides Aquino would for sure be on the major league roster, because his prodigious power would play well off the bench. Scott Kingery, another guy who's got tremendous versatility. John Ryan Murphy, he's their third string catcher. Trevor Williams, pitcher for the Pirates, I guess he's the number four starter, technically. Joey Wendell, another versatile infielder for minor league depth. Tyler Naquin, he'll be ready to step into the center field mix in case of an injury. Now, John Means, he's blossomed into the Orioles' ace on a very weak staff, but I think he deserves better than his rating here. Nomar Mazara, another young outfielder with upside, but we just have no room for him on the major league roster. Jose Alvarez, tough left-handed reliever. He's part of that Phillies pitching staff. Tommy Edmond, he's on the major league roster mostly for his versatility. I'm sensing a theme here with these infield-outfield types. G-Man Choi, he's actually the top-rated player who was a primary first baseman last season. J.D. Davis, he'll have a starting role in the Mets outfield. Alex Verdugo, this is a guy who you can dream on. He was the centerpiece in the Dodgers-Red Sox trade for Mookie Betts. Brandon Belt, he was this team's top first base option for years and will likely hold down the fort until Sano gains eligibility. Keon Broxton, speedy outfielder who's in AA for depth. Daniel Norris, I put him in AAA because even though he's technically a starter, the Tigers have been using him in three-inning stints. Scooter Jeanette, who still does not have a contract for 2020. Jordan Yamamoto, he's one of the highly promising starters on the Marlins pitching staff. Jose Urquidy should have a starting job with the Astros whenever the season ends up opening. Homer Bailey, stable veteran who signed with the Twins. And the game doesn't say which Austin Adams this is, so let's take a closer look here. Yep, the Mariners jersey confirms that this is Austin L. Adams, as opposed to Austin D. Adams, who signed with the Twins this past offseason. Tyson Ross, he has some MLB success. He'll serve as minor league depth. Jesus Sucre, the number four catcher, I believe. Now we're getting into some obscurity with Brian O'Grady. Ooh, Griffin Canning is actually a highly regarded prospect with the Angels, who's dealing with some injury troubles. And at this point, I'd like to talk a little bit about the Taurus pitching staff as regards to the player pool in MLB The Show 20. According to MLB.com's preseason rankings, the top Taurus starting pitcher would actually be A's left-handed prospect AJ Puck. Although, despite several roster updates, he still does not appear in this game. Not that Taurus had much hope of contending anyway. Although if you look at prospects like Davey Garcia and former number one overall pick Casey Mize, you've got the makings of a rotation you could dream on. Here's Luis D. Perdomo, not to be confused with Luis M. Perdomo from the early 2010s. Steven Souza Jr. signed with the Cubs over the offseason. Amir Garrett is a fiery lefty reliever. He's actually one of the players involved in the MLB The Show Players League. I kind of think he got hosed with his 69 player rating, although it is nice. One better than Trevor Richards, who was traded from the Marlins to the Rays during the season last year. Roman Quinn, a backup Phillies outfielder. Luke Gregerson is another veteran reliever who is unofficially retired. Nico Horner is going to be a big part of the Cubs infield in years to come. Speaking of Chicago prospects, Michael Kopech, once he recovers from his arm injury, is a potential ace in the making for the crosstown White Sox. There's Lucas Sims, more relief pitching depth. Wellington Castillo, he was in spring training camp with the Nationals. And Buddy Beauchers. As we get towards the bottom here, we're quickly leaving the world of MLB relevance. Although Chad Bettis has a nice story, he's a testicular cancer survivor. And now as we get into A-ball, we switch back to the custom uniforms. Ooh, Evan White actually could be the Mariners' starting first baseman. He signed a major league contract despite never having played in a big league game. But for the rest of these fellas, not so much. Even as we get back into some AA and AAA players. And it's interesting, guys like Heath Fillmyer and Brett Martin. When I initially put together these rosters, those guys each had ratings of 69. Even though now if you look at it, they're down to 65. So I guess the game automatically applies changes in player ratings from roster updates. Ooh, Kyle Freeland is actually an interesting case because he went from Cy Young contender in 2018 to negative points last year to a negative point contributor in 2019. So if he can bounce back, he could be a big part of this Taurus pitching staff. Connor Wong, another player involved in that Mookie Betts blockbuster. Sam Dyson, I actually saw him pitch for Team USA in the 2017 World Baseball Classic. Wei-Chung Wong, he briefly pitched for the A's and the Pirates last year. Ian Anderson, he's a top Braves pitching prospect. Jonathan Davis, deep, deep outfield depth for the Blue Jays. Jace Peterson, another one of those versatile, can play anywhere on the diamond types. And rounding things out is relief pitcher Mike Morin. So, as we go back to the top here, I hope you enjoyed this visual representation of the Taurus Bulls roster for the 2020 Fantasy Astrology season. Stay tuned for more roster analysis and hopefully some simulations of actual games, as we hope and pray that real baseball will be back sometime very soon.